All right, renewable energy futures. Sometimes when you're thinking about where you're going in the future, where you might want to go and how you're going to get there, it's useful to look at where you've been in the past, how you moved through there, and where you are today. So in this module, we'll look at the past of renewables, the history of renewables, the current status, and then various possible futures that may take place and what are the technologies involved. So let's start with the big picture. The long view, energy use. If you go back to 1800, world energy use, fairly stable in the 19th century, but the 20th century energy consumption just went crazy high, as shown in this graph. And it's interesting to break that out. If you go back to 1800, the predominant fuel was traditional biomass. People simply burning what they could find would be sticks and downed wood and crops and agricultural material. That's what's meant by traditional biomass. Traditional burned in an open fire of some sort. But notice the size of that really hasn't changed all that much going back two centuries or so. But starting about 1850, 1900, we had fossil fuels started to appear. First was coal, late 19th century, followed by oil, and then gas. And then these more, we call them exotics because they didn't really become significant until post about 1950, where we started to see nuclear and various other what are called modern renewables to distinguish them from traditional biomass. But from the long perspective, step back at this graph, it's clear that energy use has grown dramatically, phenomenally fast. And related is the CO2 emissions, which is of course an increasing concern and perhaps the emerging as the greatest driver and how we need to and will change how we use energy. And as energy use climbed and we switched largely to fossil fuels, coal, oil, and natural gas, then CO2 emissions rose at about the same overall pattern because the more coal, oil, and natural gas we use, the more CO2 emissions go up. But notice, a point we'll make in this course again, is that the two CO2, energy, and economic growth don't have to be linked. In other words, you could use more energy and CO2 emissions can go down if you switch to renewables. Similarly, to achieve economic growth, it doesn't require a one-to-one increase in energy use. It's possible for an economy to become more efficient and grow and have GNP growth without a corresponding one-to-one growth in energy emissions, and certainly without a one-to-one corresponding growth in CO2 emissions, a combination of improved efficiency and switching to low carbon renewables can provide economic growth without a corresponding increase in CO2 emissions. So if we began to the recent last two centuries history of the world energy use has been vast increases and a move to fossil being coal, oil, and natural gas. However, if you look at breaking down energy use, and this graph goes from 1965 to 2019 on a 100% scale, notice what's happened post 2000. There's something going on with renewables. Notice how that red percentage of the whole is starting to grow. And if you look at 2010, post 2010, it seems like the growth in renewables is accelerating. There's something going on there. So to take that apart and understand this recent trend, we'll do a case study, a more in-depth look at just one country, the USA, which is one of the largest energy users by country in the world, and taking apart some of the energy historical energy trends in the USA provides some insight. So let's start looking at the USA only, primary energy consumption. So this is all the forms of energy. And if you go back to 1780, not surprisingly, what was the primary energy use for the 19th century, roughly from 1800 to 1900? Well, it was wood, or the paragraph would have called biomass. There wasn't much available. There wasn't much use of fossil fuels. To the extent energy was used in the traditional way we talk about using energy, it was wood, wood for cooking, wood for heating. And starting about mid-1800s, coal, there was some understanding and greater use of coal as people realized that, oh, this coal that we started to find or what started to discover was really useful. If you take a chunk of coal, it'll burn a lot longer and hotter than a similar size chunk of wood. So this transition was driven by convenience, by availability, by energy density. And even though in some regions increasing urbanization, it was harder to get wood, it really wasn't that we ran out, the US ran out of wood. There was a move to coal because coal essentially worked better. It was higher energy density, it would burn hotter, it was easier to move. If you went and got a bunch of coal, that would provide more heating than a similar size or weight bunch of wood. So that, the transition was driven by convenience, availability. It's not as if we ran out of wood. That's not what happened. So let's move on to include the 20th century. There's more going on here, but essentially the 20th century was largely about fossil fuels in the US. So again, if we go back prior to 1900, mostly wood. Starting late 1880, 1890s, the rise of coal here. Starting here, the blue was the rise of oil, what this graph calls petroleum, followed shortly by the rise of natural gas. So notice, again, the 20th century was largely about fossil fuels. And those grew, though there's some variations. Coal grew steadily till 2000. Natural gas, petroleum had some changes in the 1970s, economic changes, price effects, and so on, and they started their rise again. So the U.S., the 20th century, and this is true for many, though not all countries, but it's largely about fossil fuels, as you can see down in the graph here, down in the label on the bottom. We'll take a short break here and focus on what's happening in the 21st century, because things are starting to look quite different.